Good day and welcome back. So for this video, we are going to enter the first chapter in STPM Physics Semester 3, Oscillation. So we're going to learn what is a simple harmonic motions and also the kinematics, which includes the displacement, velocity, and the oscillations, where we are going to derive and learn their formulas in terms of time. First, let's go through the definitions of simple harmonic motions. So it is a type of motions where the object has an acceleration, which is proportional to the displacement from a fixed point, and the direction is always toward the fixed point all the time. So the fixed point mentioned here is the point of equilibrium, which is something similar that you have learned in the topic of wave in Form 4 physics. So the main difference of simple harmonic motions and the linear motions that we learned in semester 1 is that the object has the acceleration that varies with the displacement. So you are given with the formula of the acceleration is equal to negative omega squared x, where the omega is the angular frequency of the motions. So we also have learned about the formula of the force, which is equal to ma. So simple harmonic motions also can be related to a resultant force, which is also proportional to the displacement from the fixed point, and it is always directed toward the fixed point all the time. Let's talk about the simple harmonic motion in a straight line. So we have the point of equilibrium in the middle of the line. So let us consider an object that is going to move to the right. So along the motions, the displacement of the object has a positive value. So we have the negative value of the accelerations or the resultant force. So this means that when object is moving to the right, the object is subjected to a force that is in opposite directions that causes the velocity of the object is decreasing. In the other words, the object is decelerating while moving to the right until the maximum distance, which is also known as the amplitude. And then the negative force will cause the object move to the left with an increasing velocity. So when the object just passed through the point of equilibrium, the direction of the force on the object will change to the right, since the point of equilibrium is now on the right side of the object. At this moment, the object has the maximum velocity at the point of equilibrium, and it will start to decelerating since the force is acting in the opposite direction of the motion. So in short, when the object is the left side of the point of equilibrium, it has the negative value of displacement and a positive value of the force, which is directed toward the point of equilibrium. So the process will continue on, and this motion is known as the simple harmonic motion. So let's talk about another example. You can recall back the experiment of pendulum that you did in secondary school. So what you did at that time is you're going to pull the pendulum at a certain angle, and then we're going to release the pendulum, and the pendulum will oscillate at a certain frequency. So here you can take note of a few things. So when object is at the maximum amplitude or the maximum distance from the point of equilibrium, so either it's on the left or on the right, the object is stopped at the moment and it has zero velocity. So the acceleration of the object is given as omega squared a, and it is always directed to the point of equilibrium. So if you are on the left, you have negative displacement and the positive accelerations and also the resultant force. While if you are on the right, you have the positive value of displacement and the negative value of the accelerations and the resultant force. At the point of equilibrium where the x is equal to zero, the object has zero accelerations, and the velocity of the object is maximum at that point. So here we are also going to refresh a few definitions. First is the amplitude that is known as the maximum distance from point of equilibrium. Second is the period that is defined as the time taken for one complete oscillations. And third is the frequency, which is defined as the number of complete oscillations per second. So remember that period is the reciprocal of the frequency, which you might need it in a few calculations later on. So after you understand what is a simple harmonic motions, so we're going to express the displacement, velocity, and the accelerations in terms of equations. So let's start with the equations of the displacement, for example, a sin omega t. So from the graph of the sine function, we can see that the position of the object is at the point of equilibrium, and it is going to start moving to the right. So next thing is the velocity of the object, which is defined as the rate of change of displacement. So perform the differentiations on the equations of displacement, and we obtain the velocity is equal to omega a cos omega t. So you plot the graph of cosine, You can see that the V is maximum when the time is equal to zero and the object is going to decelerate due to the negative force. And to obtain the expressions that is defined as the rate of change of velocity, do again the differentiations and you will obtain negative omega squared A sine omega t, where you can replace A sine omega t as the function of x. So this is how we can obtain the formula of the expressions is equal to negative omega squared x. So when you plot the graph of the accelerations, you can see that it is antiphase with the displacement. So another thing that we want to discuss is about the variations of the velocity and the accelerations with the displacement. So for the accelerations, it is quite straightforward that the acceleration is proportional to the displacement. And now we're going to derive the expression of the velocity in terms of the displacement. So we're going to start with the formula of the accelerations, where we have dvdt is equal to negative omega squared x. And then we're going to apply the chain rule that we have dvdt is equal to dvdx multiplied dx dt. And from here, we're going to rearrange the equations and we're going to perform the integrations. So in the end, we have the equations here. So from the condition that the object has zero velocity at the maximum displacement, we can obtain the constant is equal to omega squared a squared over 2. So from the complete equations and do the simplifications, in the end, you can obtain the expression of velocity as plus minus of omega multiplied by the square root of a squared minus x squared. So here you can see that we have two components of velocity, which is positive and the negative value. So recall back the motion of the pendulum. So to explain about the accelerations, it is quite straightforward. So it is positive when the object is on the left, and it is negative when the object is on the right. So the graph is only a straight line graph, which has a negative gradient. And as for the velocity, it is positive when the object is moving to the right, and it will be negative when the object is moving to the left. So the graph of velocity is something like the ellipse. So the corresponding velocity according to the value is shown in the picture. So you can do the cross-check on the graph with the picture here, and you'll find out that it is not difficult to understand about motions. So that's all for the kinematics of simple harmonic motions. If you still have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.